Welcome to the Million Dollar Deals YouTube channel. Our mission is to help you unlock your untapped potential and elevate your sales career to new heights. We're passionate about humanizing sales, fostering genuine connections, and empowering you to sell more and earn your true worth. Our channel offers expert insights, real-world experiences, and actionable advice on all aspects of B2B enterprise sales, including prospecting, negotiation, account management, and personal development. Join our community of sales professionals committed to continuous growth, collaboration, and achieving extraordinary success. Together, let's redefine the world of B2B enterprise sales, break through your barriers, and create a fulfilling career that aligns with your values and aspirations. Welcome to this week's video. We're going to talk about the three things that separate million-dollar closers from the rest. Number one. Million-dollar closers are incredibly bullish. I remember being brought into an organization that wanted to go from 10 million to 100 million. And when I first entered the organization, the CEO sat me down and had a conversation with me and said, look, I know what you're like. I know you're like a bull in a china shop. What I need to do is put bubble wrap around you so that you can succeed within the context of this organization. See, within that organization, everybody was a little bit soft. They weren't really driven. They weren't really pushing hard. They had a laissez-faire type of attitude towards business growth. And here I am as a business expert that is hungry for growth, that wants to push forward, that wants to do things that we've never done before, that wants to elevate to the next level. But the organization didn't really have that culture. And so the CEO needed to say to me, you need to change your approach with this particular organization to get people on your side in order to propel you forward. See, nobody does million-dollar deals on their own. Selling is a team sport. You need to be able to get people around you to support your mission and support your cause to support the deals. I remember when I was first starting out in my sales career, I used to sit down with solutions engineers and I used to say to them, hey, I've got this opportunity for us to work on. And they used to sit down and say, hold on a minute, you know, have you qualified this opportunity? Tell me about the customer context. Is this a real opportunity? Almost as if these people didn't actually want to work on the deals with me. And I had to put forward these compelling business cases just to get support to help me close these million-dollar deals. So don't forget that selling is a team sport. So whilst million-dollar closers are incredibly bullish and they're incredibly driven and we're incredibly motivated and we lead with power, we also need to remember that we can't alienate people. We need to get people on side. We need to develop a good level of empathy so that we can evangelize the vision and the mission to the individuals that we're working with so that they can support us to close the million-dollar deal. So remember in life that every strength creates a weakness. For instance, if my strength is that I'm incredibly bullish and I'm incredibly driven and ambitious more than the average person, then the weakness is that sometimes I might alienate people in the pursuit of my goals. What we need to do is develop a great level of self-awareness to maximize our strengths and minimize our weaknesses, because there's no good on doing it in your own. The old saying goes, if you want to go fast, go alone. And if you want to go further, go with others. So we need to remember that in the world of million-dollar deals, we have to do it together. It has to be a team sport. We can't burn people around us with our ambition. We need to make sure that we slow it down. We take a moment to breathe. We plan and we do it properly and we bring people on board for the journey. All right, number two, we don't treat the deal as the goal. No, a lot of salespeople treat the deal as the goal. That's what they're working to. The goal is to get this deal. The goal is to get this deal. No, I have a completely different philosophy and mindset on that one. My goal is to help the customer make the right decision. Whether it's a yes, whether it's a no, is irrelevant to me. I'm not attached to the outcome. What I'm attached to is the process of helping the customer make a decision. Now, the reason I do that is because if you look at the data, most sales happen between 8 or 9 touch points. That's not even in enterprise sales. In enterprise sales, there might be 50 touch points. There might be 100 touch points. There might be conferences that you need to run. There might be webinars that you need to run specifically for that organization. I mean, in some of the million-dollar deals that I've done, I've had to fill a room with 30 analysts within the large bank to help them understand the technology that we were talking about. It was a cybersecurity solution in order to get that deal across the line. So that's 30 touch points in one session that I had to do in order to get this deal across the line, because I needed enough supporters within the organization to help me push that deal into the executive and to push it forward. So the other thing that statistic reveals in enterprise sales is that you can't give up. Most people give up before they get to the 8th or 10th or 20th or 30th touch point. The reason I don't give up is because I'm not attached to the deal. I don't think to myself, I'm not going to get this deal. I don't think like that. The way that I think is, have I helped the customer make a decision? I need a yes or a no. If it's a no, that's okay, because I'm going to direct my efforts on something that I know will drive results. But if it's a yes and you need more information to help us drive forward, then I'm there to support you to get to a decision. What obstacles do you have? What stakeholders do you need to convince? Who are the naysayers within the account that I need to help you convince so that we can push this deal forward? See, if you develop that level of resilience and you don't get attached to the outcome, but you're attached to the journey, i.e. helping them make a decision, then I guarantee you will do more multi-million dollar deals. Number three, they're focused on executive presence, and I split this down into two categories. Category number one is that themselves, they present as an executive. They show up, they're dressed nice, your hair's done, you have a good vocabulary, you have a firm handshake. You're not laxed or colloquial in your language. You are formal and responsible because you're a trusted advisor. Every trusted advisor has a level of polish. And I remember early in my career, we talked about this notion called polish. You need a level of polish to be able to get to the executive level and carry that executive presence. Even to the point that when I was really young in my sales career, there was a gentleman, I'll never forget him. He kind of looked like James Bond. He had that beautiful British accent, and he was just a sophisticated man. And I remember being young in my sales career, and I had all these new shirts and all these things that I would wear, and my shirt had a pocket on it. And I remember we had lunch one day with the team, and he said to me, "Oscar, that pocket in your shirt tells me that it's a cheap shirt. You need to make sure that when you buy shirts, there are no pockets on both sides." So what did I do? I went and bought shirts with no pockets. They were a little bit more expensive because executives don't carry things. They don't stuff things around in them. They don't have bulky pockets. We're streamlined. We don't have a lot of baggage. We make decisions clearly. So all of that stuff really matters. The other thing that he said to me was that he had a Breitling watch, and he said, "You have to have a great watch." And so I went out and bought a Tag Heuer. And then I bought another Tag Heuer, and now I wear a Rolex. This is one of the things that impacts you at a subconscious level, is to present well and carry that level of executive presence. Work on your vocabulary, work on your handshake, and see who you could become. So the first part of that was about presenting and being an executive. The second part of that is being able to get in front of executives. Now, I have a rare framework that I've established on some other videos, which you can go and watch, to get in front of executives. What you really need to be doing is focusing on those executives. I can't tell you how many sales teams I've turned around where I'll go and work with the sales team, and I'll see very clearly that the sales team is locked in to one relationship within each of their key accounts, and they can't get outside of the bounds and the scope of that relationship. That is a bad relationship in an enterprise perspective, because people move around all the time. There are so many influences to do with getting your deal done. You have to go deep and you have to go wide within your accounts to ensure that you give yourself the best chance of success. So you have to be able to present as an executive to get that trust and credibility and get that executive buy-in. Otherwise, you're going to stay behind the pack. You're going to become irrelevant, and nobody's going to want to talk to you or purchase your solution, and you're not going to be successful in enterprise sales. Look, I know today's content will be incredibly valuable if you implement what it is that I tell you, and I want to tell you about a few things really quickly. Number one, you can get a free copy of my book, Million Dollar Deals, in the comments below. You can download that and read the 4 enterprise sales archetypes that you need in order to be successful, and the 11 vitality points that you need to be sustainable in your enterprise sales career. Also, there's a link to our podcast below. You can click on that and listen to that when you're driving to work or getting to work. There's also a community below, the Commission Catalyst, where you can join and you can get access to all of the content that we have and the catch-up that we run to help you elevate your sales career. All right, guys, that's all for today. I'm Oscar Chavez. Thank you very much for tuning in, and stay tuned on all of our other content to help you sell more and make more. See you next time.